I want to leap over buildings, want to fly over the shores, save the people from the villains, catch the crooks who rob the stores, write my name upon the sky, and when you call me, I'll be there, faster than a lightning flash, rushing through the cool night air. Oh, 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 so start ignition, count to zero. I just wanna be a superhero. Oh, 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 with fearless thoughts, emotions swirled, I wanna be the man that saves the world. Full of super problems, so we made up a Superman, but he is just imaginary, and here we stand without a plan, with new ideas and innovation. Man still cannot tame creation, and though I'm told I'll never fly, that doesn't mean that I won't. Oh, 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 so start ignition, count to zero. I just wanna be a superhero.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Mike Goodwin, the Executive Director of the Boys and Girls Club of Souhegan Valley. We are very excited to have you join us tonight for our virtual charity night for kids, our second virtual charity night for kids. As much as we'd all like to be celebrating in person and hosting 250 people at the club for this event, we just felt that keeping people safe was a priority, especially with the holidays right around the corner. I can tell you that I hope this is the last time we'll be producing this event virtually, and I personally look forward to seeing all of you here next year for an in-person event at the Boys and Girls Club. It's one that you don't want to miss. Funds from tonight's event are going to help to support the families served by the club, along with our general operations. The theme for this evening, as you probably have noticed, is superheroes. We felt it was appropriate because so many of you out there are superheroes. So what is the definition of a superhero? What makes someone a superhero? Well, according to Google, the definition of a superhero is a person who does heroic deeds and has the ability to do them in a way that a normal person couldn't. So in order to be a superhero, you need a power that is more exceptional than any power a normal human could possibly possess. And you need to use that power to accomplish good deeds. How appropriate. Tonight, we will introduce you to several people that are superheroes to so many, and although they may not have the powers that Superman or Spider-Man may have, they use their powers and resources to accomplish good deeds, particularly in our community. We are grateful to all of our superheroes that have impacted the club in a positive way. Tonight will be a celebration where we come together to highlight the impact our local superheroes have on our members and our families. We will also acknowledge and thank many of our sponsors. With their support, tonight would not be possible. We would like to start by thanking our event sponsor, the Amato family. We are so grateful for years of support and dedication and personal time given to the club year in and year out. Thank you, Paul and Nancy. We'd also like to thank our dream sponsors for their year-long support of our club and our members. This year, our dream sponsors are Hitchner Manufacturing Company, Edward Jones Investments, New Hampshire Custom Builder, Aline Candles, Sertronics Corporation, Contemporary Automotive. Thank you to our dream sponsors.
My name is Rod Harrell. I'm president and CEO of Aline Candles here in Milford. We've been a supporter of the Boys and Girls Club for really the entire life of the business. I personally have been a supporter and a donor for 13 years. So I think the Boys and Girls Club here in Souhegan Valley, one, their mission is right on, right? Taking care of the kids and families, providing support so that parents can get out and work, so kids have something to do in a very constructive way. Two, they're very efficient with how they spend money, how they use our donations, and that gives me incredible satisfaction knowing that our contributions are really going to the kids. And finally, incredible community support, right? All the people who are here tonight are doing so because we believe in the mission and how they execute. And I, as part of Aline and me as an individual, really excited to be a part of that. We could not do what we're doing without the employees and the people of the community that enable us to exist. So us giving back is just part of that cycle.
I'm Audrey Hammer, and this is my husband, David Hammer. We are involved here in Milford. We are the owners of Contemporary Automotive, and I have been a board member at the Boys and Girls Club for over 5 years now. Through our business, we see a direct result that the club has on the community. Unbeknownst to us, until we got involved with the club, we've had several employees who have come to the club as kids, gone through the club. A lot of them have really said it's shaped who they are and helped them be as successful at whatever they've chosen to do.
And we've got other employees who right now work for us and they have kids, they have their right. own kids coming to the club as club kids. And that's more of a want than a need. And it's just exciting to see that these kids are looking for a way to be involved in a bigger community of peers. And they're finding safety and fun and excitement and nourishment and all those things that you get at the Boys and Girls Club here in Souhegan Valley. And that's a big reason why we'd like to support the club, because it's a very positive environment.
It's really great to be a part of this event tonight. We're really excited to be here. I'm John Morrison, Chairman and Chief Executive Officer of Hitchner Manufacturing and a lifelong resident of the Souhegan Valley. I have a confession to make. I haven't always supported the Boys and Girls Club. When I was a small boy growing up in the Souhegan Valley, there weren't a lot of organizations like this around here. And boys like me had to figure out what we did with our spare time when school wasn't in session. And some of us didn't always make the right decisions. When I moved away from the area and then came back, I noticed that some of my friends who weren't really the ones making the right decisions were supporting the Boys and Girls Club as it went through its evolution. And I was really impressed by what they were doing and thought it would be great to be able to contribute, because they were offering a service that we didn't have when we were growing up. And over time, it's really gotten to be an incredible organization. And I'm really proud that we're in the position to be able to support it. And so I do whenever we can. If I had to name a superhero for this organization, it would be Steve Damaris. He's the guy who single-handedly extracted more money and commitment from me to support this place than anybody else. And he's usually here doing it in person tonight, but I'll deal with him virtually as this goes along. So Mike, thanks very much for having me. Be assured that Steve is going to extract his pound of shekels from me tonight. And it's back to you to raise more to make this place as great as it can be. Thanks.
The Boys and Girls Club has been serving the Souhegan Valley for over 30 years. During that time, we've seen thousands of kids come through our doors. From the early years at the Grange, which many of you remember, to our current facility we have called home since 2004. This building has seen countless of performances on our theater stage and hours of fun spent in our clubhouse, gymnasium, and our teen center. Over the past couple years, we're very proud to say that we now have unit clubs located in Antrim and Greenfield Elementary Schools, allowing us to expand our reach and serve more kids. Let me take a quick moment and share the club's mission with all of you. Our mission is to enable all young people, especially those who need us most, to be great today and reach their full potential as productive, caring, responsible citizens tomorrow. This mission is what drives the work of our staff and board, and together we strive to ensure that we are held to that mission by the families we serve. Tonight you will hear from some of those families, alumni, staff, donors, and members of our board. You will hear firsthand how the club has had an impact on our members' lives and on the families we serve, and why our supporters believe in what we do. I don't have to tell you that the past year and a half has been a difficult time for all of us. During this time, the club had to adapt to the constant changes the pandemic has challenged us with. Through it all, the club has continued to have safety of our members, staff, and community in mind. I'm proud of the work that our staff and board members have done to make sure that the club has continued to play a vital role in our community, so families can get back to work and know that their children are safe and cared for during those critical before and after school hours. Support for our club from the community has been amazing during this time. We are forever grateful to all of you. So let's take a moment and see where we're at with donations for this evening.
$26,475. What a great way to start tonight. For those of you that are watching tonight on your phones or don't have access to a computer, you can text your donation by texting For the Kids, all one word, For the Kids, to 366-283.
I am honored to be a part of this event tonight, and my name is Katie Leishman. I am the mother of twin 13-year-old boys, and I have survived 13 years. Woo! I wish more people knew about the Boys and Girls Club and everything it has to offer. It's to know that my kids are being cared for. I mean, like, they're genuinely cared for here. Everybody here knows my kids. They care about my kids. And all of the activities that are available to my kids, after school activities, during vacations, to know that my kids are here and they're safe. Every single person that I have encountered here means so much to me.
Hi, my name is Austin. My favorite superhero is Batman, and my real favorite superhero is my mom and dad.
I am Lila, and my favorite superhero is Captain Man. And my real favorite superhero was my baby brother, Desmond.
I'm Cammy. My favorite superhero, Wonder Woman, because who doesn't love a female superhero? Great. And I think my favorite real-life superhero would be my adopted parents, because without them, I wouldn't be here. And God knows where I'd be. And my life's great now that I'm, like, here. So they're, like, my real-life superheroes. And, like, my older brother, because, like, I look up to him.
Hi, my name is Landon. My favorite superhero is probably Captain America, and my real-life superheroes are my parents, because they're always there when I need them.
Hi, my name is Alice, and my favorite superhero is Black Widow, and my favorite counselor here is Maddie.
My name is Riley, and my favorite superhero would probably be Iron Man, and my real-life superhero would definitely be my cousin, because he's athletic, he's nice, and he also likes to help people.
Hi, my name is Noah. My favorite superhero is Iron Man or Spider-Man. My real-life superhero is probably the person who runs the Boys and Girls Club.
My name is Nora. My favorite superhero is Supergirl. And my real-life superhero is my dad.
My name is Aiden. My favorite superhero is Spider-Man.
Our goal this evening is to raise funds that will allow us to continue to have a positive impact on our youth with safe, quality, and affordable care. Here are a few ways that you can help support the club tonight. The first is to help share this video. Please take a moment, if you're on Facebook, as I'm sure many of you are, or YouTube, you could share this video with your friends and family. The second way you can help is by making a direct donation to the club. You can make the donation by going to svbgc.org/forthekids. We greatly appreciate your support no matter the size of the donation. Every little bit helps. Finally, Rich and Linda Lowney have generously sponsored our golden ticket raffle. Three winners will be drawn with a chance to win $1,000 each. You may continue to purchase tickets for your chance throughout the evening. The drawing is going to take place on November 30th. We will update you on our progress as we strive to reach our goal of $300,000 tonight.
Man, we need help with a lot of things. Things like there is a sewing center in the steam center, in the steam room, and those sewing machines need some help. I know how to repair them, but there's parts that I need to repair these sewing machines. So things like that. There are, in the teen room, there's a hockey table that the boys can play on, or that the kids can play on. I have two boys. And I know that parts are broken off of that. There's a ping pong table that I think it's missing a leg. I know that our air hockey table that the kids love just died, and it's beyond my scope of repair. So that's gonna need some love. Ping pong tables, again, are a big hit around here, but they don't work so good if we don't have nets attached to them, and so we need nets on those. We both really look forward to coming here. So anything that anybody can donate, we are, as a family, immensely grateful. Thank you, Mike, for having me. And again, it has been my honor. And let's work on getting those donations in. Good luck, everybody. Have a great evening.
My name is Emerson, and my favorite superhero is Superman. And my real life superhero is my dad.
My name's Helena, and my favorite superhero would be Wonder Woman, and my real-life superhero is going to be my mom.
Hi, my name is Austin. My favorite superhero is Black Widow, and my favorite counselor is Alexa.
So I'm Kylie Gellidge. I'm great, I know. And my favorite hero would probably be Pitbull, because, you know, Mr. Worldwide, Mr. 305. Love you, Pitbull. And I'd say a real hero would be my mom, because without her, I wouldn't be here today, and she's done so much for me. So yeah, thanks, Mom.
The second way you can help is by making a direct donation to the club. You can make that donation by going to svbgc.org/forthekids. We greatly appreciate your support no matter the size of your gift. Finally, Rich and Linda Lowney have generously sponsored our golden ticket raffle. Three winners will be drawn for a chance to win $1,000 each. It'll be coming very useful in the holiday season. You may continue to purchase your tickets throughout the evening. The drawing will take place on November 30th. We will update you on our progress as we strive to reach our goal of $300,000 raised tonight. Let's go ahead and take a look at where we are right now.
And as of right now, I can tell you that we're at $79,423 raised for this event. Again, just an incredible amount of money, and thank you so much for supporting us tonight. For those of you that are watching tonight on your phones or don't have access to a computer, you can text your donation by texting For the Kids, all one word, For the Kids, to 366-283.
Wow, this is amazing and a great start to the evening. This community never ceases to amaze me with its generosity, as evidenced here so far. Thank you so much for all your support. At this time, I would like to recognize our wonder sponsors for this evening. Those are Gringotts Fun for Muggles, Vault 713, Josh Larrabee and Sarah Mata Larrabee. Thank you both. To get our program started, I'd like to introduce a video from our board president, Joelle Martin. Joelle, take it away.
Hi, everyone. I'm Joelle Martin, and I have the pleasure of being president of the board this year for the Boys and Girls Club of Souhegan Valley, that we love to call the club. It's really my pleasure to be here tonight and to celebrate this great place for our kids that I think of as the heart of our Souhegan Valley community. for our kids and families. I really think of the club as a place where kids can be themselves, feel like they belong, and it's a place where they can learn, grow, and reach their full potential. I'm honored, and it's been a pleasure to be on the board for the past 5 years. And we are so fortunate in this community to have so many community members committed to the healthy development of our kids and youth. And I'd like to take the time tonight to thank our sponsors and our supporters, because you truly are superheroes to our kids. As you know, the club is a 501c3, a nonprofit, and the staff, we cannot do this work without your support, so thank you. Also, community members watching, if you haven't had the chance to support the club, I invite you to join us tonight. You know, whether you've attended a show at the Amato Center, or a community event hosted by the Prevention Coalition cast, or been at a sports event in the gym, or just heard great things about the club and about the staff's commitment to supporting our kids so that they can all become superheroes. Thanks so much for your support. Any amount can truly contribute and help these kids become the superheroes they're meant to be. And thanks for joining us tonight. Now, Mike, back to you.
All right, thank you very much, Joelle. Now I'd like to share a special video message from a few of our club families as they share why the club is important to them. As you listen, please note that it's the money raised tonight that will help enable us to continue to provide for families and youth like them.
My name is Donna Gullidge, and my kids Kylie Gullidge and Chase Gullidge come to the Boys and Girls Club. They have been a part of the Boys and Girls Club for about, I believe this is the fourth year. And I can't get these kids away from these people. I don't know what it is. It makes me want to join the Boys and Girls Club, but I can't because I'm too old. Honestly, I feel like they're like our second family, and this is like a second home for them, which I love because I don't ever have to worry about them. I know they're always in good hands, and I know everyone here at the Boys and Girls Club is always looking out for them and all the other kids, and just having them in our lives has helped me tremendously. And as a single mom, it's a lot of support for us. You know, this is, I know I'm not the only single parent out there, but it's just nice to have that support. And they've been there through me financially, emotionally, and I don't know what else more to say other than this is a great community for our children, and I highly recommend any child to come here, even if it's just for a few hours a week or every day, but my children have grown a lot. Boys and Girls Club, thank you very much for everything you've done for all of us. I don't know what I'm gonna do when the kids are grown up, because they will outgrow this place, but it's only because they're older and, you know, they're gonna start their own lives. But I do hope this place never leaves us at all. You know, it's always gonna be a constant memory for us. So thank you, Boys and Girls Club.
Hi, I'm really excited to be here tonight. Thanks for inviting us. My name is Bernice Handy. This is my granddaughter,
Kehlani Figueroa.
And we're here to talk about our experience at the Souhegan Valley Boys and Girls Club, and it has been a tremendous one. So I've raised Kehlani since she was 10, and she got introduced to the Boys and Girls Club at that time. And she was part of a resiliency retreat program that was started by Monica Gallant. It's helped Kehlani tremendously. One of their goals was to teach them the keys of success, which, what do you think, Kehlani? How were the keys of success for you? Did you use them?
Yeah.
And she still has them hanging on her door, as a matter of fact. And she also learned to find her voice because she was very shy, and she gained a lot of experience doing that.
This program has taught me how to find my voice, and it's given me more confidence to try and better myself every day. It's a youth-led group who look in their community for things that they find they want to improve on. I think it's a great thing because when other people get help, then they pass it on. And then it's like a chain, and then everyone gets the help they need and the support and the love that they need.
So again, I just can't thank you enough for all the wonderful programs that are here. the CAST program Kehlani's a big part of and all the opportunities that she's had to grow and be inspired.
My hero is my grandmother because she was always there for me and she supported me every step of the way. And she never gives up on me and always helps me become the best version of myself. She's just amazing and I love her so much.
Hi, thank you for having me. I'm super excited to be here. My name's Jennifer and my son started coming to the Boys and Girls Club in the summer of 2020 when the state granted it the ability to open for the Children of Essential Employees. As a healthcare professional, I was enormously relieved to have a safe and enriching place for him to go. When the school year started, Max was able to work on his remote learning here. He had a desk set up with his Chromebook, with all of his necessities. Even his teachers commented on how great the setup was. Then as school started opening for in-person learning, he's continued to come to the Boys and Girls Club before and after school, and every single day I get to hear about all the great things that he does, from the STEAM program to positive action. He's performed science and engineering experiments. He's taken swim lessons here during summer camp. He recently joined the Riverbend Youth Company that performs right here at the Amato Center. So all of this is centered around the Boys and Girls Club. It's really become the hub of our family's activities. And I am so grateful to the faculty and staff here for creating such a caring and uplifting environment for him to thrive. I hope you guys have such a great night. I hope you raise lots of money and continue to be able to provide these programs for our community and our children. Have an awesome night.
Amazing. Great stories. I hope that you can see how important the club is and the impact it can have on so many. As we go through the program tonight, I remind you, with your support and generosity, the club is able to provide the needed mentoring and healing support through our programs such as the Resiliency Program, theater performances, STEAM education, arts, team program, all of which creates a lifetime of impact on our youth. Our next level of sponsors we would like to recognize is our Cape Crusader sponsors. These sponsors are Chiodelli Fuel and Flynn Construction. Thank you so much to our Cape Crusader sponsors.
Hi, my name is Ellie McGuire, and I am one of the mentors for the Children's Resilience Retreat that meets one Saturday a month during the school year for about 20 some kids in the area who have had addiction affect them severely in their families. This program is built on community support for the kids. And one of the things that we stress in the program is a strong community, and that includes not only the mentors that are here, the adults in the kids' lives, their parents and such, but everybody on the street and in the area of Milford or at school that they come in contact with. And so as a community, we all need to support each other. We need to be that network for our kids and for everybody who's going through mental health issues. There's a lot. Everywhere, and we don't think it's right here in Milford, but it is. And these kids benefit from all the support, all the donations, little or large.
Hello, my name is Malia, and my favorite superhero would probably have to be Catwoman. And my favorite staff here is probably Caitlin.
My name's Adele, and my favorite superhero is probably Wonder Woman, and my favorite real superhero is my mom.
My name is Max, and my favorite superhero is Deadpool. My favorite real life superhero is Pitbull.
My name's Allison. My favorite superhero is Wonder Woman, and my real life superhero is my sister.
Good evening. My name is Allie McKnight. I'm 28 years old, and I'm a third-year law student at Northeastern University School of Law in Boston. I'm also a former assistant to Mayor Jim Donchus in Nashua and a former vice president of community engagement at New Futures in New Hampshire. I'm a 2011 alum of Souhegan High School, but most importantly, I'm a former youth counselor at the Boys and Girls Club of Souhegan Valley and a former member of the Riverbend Youth Company. All of the work I've done as a professional has centered around facilitating community and belonging, and also facilitating connections between people that empower community-led change. I learned how to do that work with love, first from my awesome parents, and second from the Boys and Girls Club of Souhegan Valley. At the Boys and Girls Club, I was constantly told that I was loved, that I was worthy, and that I was important. I was told it so often that it was harder not to believe in myself than it was to believe in myself. I learned how to be a great friend during summer around the bend traveling productions. I learned how to have fun backstage at the Amato Center. I learned to be a storyteller on stage at the Amato Center. I learned to be patient as a volunteer in the preschool room. And I learned to be creative and good-humored and probably patient again as a summer camp counselor at Camp Souhegan. And as an adult, every time I re-enter the Boys and Girls Club, I remember that I have the responsibility to give as many kids as possible what I was blessed to be given in the walls of our club. That's why I'm becoming an attorney and an advocate. Great Futures Start Here isn't just a slogan. It's my lived reality. I thank you all so much for helping me to be great and for supporting the next generation of kids in the Souhegan Valley in building their great futures. Have a great night.
Hi, I'm Alec Connolly, and I was at the club from 2007 to 2014. I went on and I attended the University of New Hampshire, and I graduated there in May of 2018. I'm now living here in New York City, pursuing a career in acting. I think my best memory of the club is definitely all the friends that I got to meet while doing shows there and working there. I still keep in touch with a lot of them today. The club was such a great place to meet new friends and meet different friends than, you know, the kids I went to high school with. So that was really cool, and it really broadened my horizons, and I got to meet new people. I got to meet people out of my age group and just mingle and connect and really have an awesome time while I was there. While I was at the club, I did mostly shows from when I was 11 to when I was 18, and doing the alumni shows and all of that. And Robin really had the biggest impact on me. She saw me through thick and thin, and she was there, I mean, from the beginning when my mom introduced me to her when I was a small 11-year-old going into my very first audition, not really knowing what to expect. And so Robin really was there to hold my hand through it all. And even now, I mean, I'm still in touch with her and getting advice from her. Like I said, right now I'm living here in New York City. I just finished up shooting a short film with a colleague of mine that should be coming out fairly soon. And then mainly I've just been auditioning and doing shows at summer stock theaters, at regional theaters. Last June, I did a production right here in New York City. So I've been really having a blast while I've been. I've definitely taken all the lessons that I've learned and all the memories with me throughout college, and even now I still have great memories, and I'm able to scroll through old production photos, and I mean, now with social media, it's so easy to keep in contact with friends like that. And so the club has really shaped me. Little did I know it when I was 11 years old walking into those doors.
We can provide support to our youth and our families, then we can have a healthier community.
We've taken some time over the past few months and come up with a theme to kind of spread awareness to the community we feel that we need to work on.
This year's theme is peace, diversity, acceptance, and inclusion. It's good to have a community together, especially in a time like this. There's a pandemic going on, and it's really difficult for a lot of people and their mental health and stuff. So it's really good to have something like this going on to help them out and let them know that we're still a community and we still got this.
It means a lot kind of seeing it all come together, seeing all these kids happy. Because not only is it helping them and having a lot of fun kind of getting out and seeing things, it's also informing them of not to use drugs and substances, and kind of is giving them that theme in their head of the peace, diversity, acceptance, and inclusion, and how they can all feel safe based on their differences and who they are as a person. So I really am proud to see all of this come together in such a short amount of time.
My name is Michelle, and my favorite superhero is Wonder Woman. And my favorite real-life superhero is my mom, because she's my favorite person, and I really love her, so.
My name is Alala, and my favorite superhero is Wonder Woman. And my real-life favorite superhero is my friend Lila.
I'm Trevor Boucher. My favorite superhero is Batman, and my favorite real life superhero is my dad.
My name is Angie, and my favorite superhero is Wonder Woman, and my real life superhero is Izzy.
Hi, my name is Grace. My favorite superhero is Wonder Woman, and my real life superhero is my sister, because she's there when I need her to be, when I have problems at school or something. She's always there for me.
I now want to talk about what the funds raised tonight will go to support. We have four areas we're asking for support in this evening. First, program operations. Having the support to hire quality staff, operate impactful programs that can help change the life of a child is a critical piece of what we do, and we need that support. Our second area needed tonight is for our theater. No program at the club felt the impact of COVID as much as the theater has. It has been a challenge to provide programming theater options under the regulations we've had to abide by. That is starting to ease up, and now this year we're looking at a very exciting theater year. As we look at the future of the theater program, there are long overdue and needed improvements that our theater will have to address. We hope that you can support these improvements and help us continue to have a top quality theater program for our youth and the community. A third area of need is transportation. And that seems to happen every year we talk about transportation. Some of you may not realize that we transport kids to and from school in the Souhegan Valley area, including Amherst and Wilton. Maintaining a safe fleet of vehicles that can safely get kids to and from the club is essential. As we continue to grow and serve more youth, transportation plays a critical piece in making sure we have the means to get our kids to and from school. Our final need is for scholarship assistance. Though most of our fees are very low, there's still need out there for help. Families are having a tough time putting food on their plates, paying for gas, along with all the other ways inflation is currently impacting their budgets. As a result, we're seeing an increase in scholarship applications. Your support tonight will help us ensure that members will have access to scholarship support. As we state in our mission, we are here for all young people, and we will continue to be there for our members through this crisis now and into the future. So please make a donation tonight so that we can continue to perform our mission and provide needed services to all our families. Thank you. I would now like to recognize another level of sponsors this evening. Those are our Justice League sponsors, and they are
Adam Valancourt Roofing and Construction, Control Air, Enterprise Bank, Joel Martin and Don Brzezinski, Leach Automotive, MD's Recycling and Waste Removal, Bob and Sue Heaton, Jim Duggan, Weiner and Bennett, and Paul and Susan Spies. It's our Wonder sponsors, the Larrabee family, and Gringotts Fund for Muggles Vault 713.
Special thanks to our Cape Crusader sponsors this evening. Those are Flink Construction, Chiodelli Fuel, Apple Therapy Services, Shannon Chanley and Tom Sylvia, Elysian Technologies, and Wright Networks. I would also like to recognize our X-Men sponsors for this evening, and those are
Souhegan Valley Dental, Brennan and McKay Appliances.
Finally, we'd like to thank the fantastic sponsors for tonight.
Co-working House, Innovative Test Solutions, Linen and Shade Bin, Mark and Catherine Parenti, Odin Building Automation Systems, Peter and Ann Webb, the Frank Masson Agency, St. Mary's Bank, and Speed Pro Solutions. Thank you all for your support.
Spider sponsors include the following:
BPRK, Leighton and White Incorporated, Datron Dynamics, CGI Business Solutions, Bar Harbor Bank and Trust, High Ten Plastics, Nathan Wexler and Company, Papa Joe's Humble Kitchen, The Colony Group, Law Office of Thomas F. Quinn, and Mark and Ruthie Fugere. Thank you.
We are so grateful to all our sponsors. They are what make this event so special and help us do the great work that we do. Speaking of support, I'd like to turn my attention to a group of individuals who did not get a lot of credit or attention, and that group is our board of directors. Right now, we have a group of 20 men and women who have played an important role in our success, especially during the pandemic. Some of our board members have been here from the very beginning. During the past year and a half, our board has continued to meet virtually in board meetings, committee meetings, and have gone above and beyond to support the staff during these challenging times. The club would not be here today if it was not for them, as well as our past board members who helped set the stage. We have a special message for from just the one of those board members on why the club is so important to him. Ron?
Hey, Mike, thanks for inviting me to this event again this year. I mean, I'm really excited to be part of it. And as most of you know, I'm Ron Troy. I'm a board of director member, and I've been a board member since 2007. You know, I've been a member of the community for a long time now, and I really love working with kids. I've been a hockey coach for over 30 years. Love helping kids like achieve their goals, and I love being part of trying to shape their lives to help them achieve greatness. A lot of people have come into our lives that have obviously molded all of us, and it's nice that we can give back to some of the kids in the community. You know, in today's environment, families are really transient. Like, people don't spend a lot of time in their communities anymore. When I was a young kid, I was playing street hockey out in the street. And when you come into this facility, one of my most memorable events was when I walked into our new gym and I saw a police officer playing goalie in the floor hockey game. So that connection to the community and that ability for us to reach to kids and say, we're part of a community, you can be part of this and make changes and make great things happen in the community. And that's why this is so important to me. I have a personal connection to this club because my youngest child worked here, grew up in the theater, and I saw my kid just develop into an amazing individual through the theater and the ability to stand in front of hundreds of people and talk to them when I'm sitting here as a business executive saying, wait a minute, I couldn't do that. And I've been in front of lots of people before. So it developed my own child. My child now is in the school system as a counselor, helping little kids. And I think part of the reason he chose that as a career is because of the events that occurred here and the kids that have impacted him. And I think that's something that's really important, is that we are building on that foundation of creating a greater community.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us. As a board member for the Souhegan Valley Boys and Girls Club, it is my absolute pleasure and privilege to sit on the programming committee. And I wanted to share with you a little bit about my experience there. With the ever-changing landscape of information and suggestions of operation that the pandemic has brought for us, one thing that has never changed for this club is the commitment to deliver top-notch, engaging programming to the children who come to the club. The families and the children of the community are consistently the priority of the club, and for that, I am forever grateful and incredibly proud.
And while speaking of board members, this past year, the club lost one of its longest-serving board members and a true superhero to not only the club, but the community, Alan Wolfson. His spirit is always with us at the club, guiding us in a way that only Alan could. We're grateful to him and his family for his service to this organization. He will continue to be missed. Thank you, Alan. Let's take a quick look and see how we're doing with our donations and support tonight.
We are at $149,635 raised, well on our way to meeting our goal for this evening.
Just a friendly reminder to head over to our website, svbgc.org/forthekids, and make your donation now. As I've stated, any donation amount is greatly appreciated. It will help us continue our mission and provide the support for our families that they deserve. Now, we'd like to share a brief video from our theater youth. Please enjoy.
Days where she feels unstoppable. Of course, those days come to an end. Fortunately, Alice is happy with love to help her up and guide her through the good days. We'll be right back. confidence. But of course, where there's a high, a low is in the future.
That's great. I'm always so amazed at the work that these members can do. The joy on the kids' faces after a performance is truly priceless. Robin and her team have had thousands of kids come through the theater doors and onto that stage. It amazes me how these kids pour their passion for theater into their performances. Our club and the community is so grateful for the theater program. Many of our members have been recognized by Boys and Girls Clubs of America and been invited to perform at many national conferences over the years. They have performed in New York City, New Orleans, San Diego, Florida, and Chicago. Thank you again to those that have supported the theater program over the years. Our members are truly grateful. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Molly, and my superhero is my Nana. And my favorite staff member is Maddie.
My name is Isabella, and my favorite superhero is Wonder Woman. And then my real life superhero is my dad.
Hello, my name is Tristan. My favorite superhero is Batman. My two real life superheroes are my dad, which he passed away a couple years ago, and my grandpa. He's there with me at any time. My dad is always in my heart.
My name is Ian, and my favorite superhero Spider-Man. My real life favorite superhero is my mom.
My name is Stella. My favorite superhero is Hulk, and my real life superhero is Abby because she's nice and she takes care of me and she helps me when I need help.
Hi, I'm Aster, and my favorite superhero is Wonder Woman, and my real life superhero is my mom because she's always there for me.
As we come to the end of our night, our families and communities are living in a time of unrest and uncertainty. As an organization, our hope is to provide a better place where our kids feel safe, loved, appreciated, and have some sense of normalcy in their lives. We will continue to adapt and change to be the best for our kids and their families. We thank you again for tuning in tonight and for making a donation. Please help us again by sharing this video. Do not forget, on November 30th, we'll be drawing our three golden ticket winners, each sponsored by Rich and Linda Lowney, on Facebook Live. There's still plenty of time to buy your tickets. You can buy those tickets right up until November 29th. Thank you again for joining us tonight, and a final thank you to our sponsors, board, staff, and families. We have one last video from some of our special friends who would like to say thank you. So thank you all, and be safe.
Thank you so much, and remember that you can continue to give at www.svbgc.org/for the kids, and we'll continue to accept donations through the end of this month. Thank you so much. Have a great night.